Josh, he will continue to struggle finding hacks that fit his giant head. And he will never be decisive enough to pick where to eat for dinner. But he will also continue to love and protect you as he did yesterday. And Victoria, she will continue to have an original fear of Jews. And already has become a new favorite daughter-in-law of the Russell household. But she will also continue to love and admire you as she did yesterday.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to have everybody's attention to the entryway on my left. Let's go ahead and have everybody stand up. So if you're sitting, let's go ahead and stand up. For who we came here to see tonight, Mr. and Mrs. Russell.
Regardless of how opinionated or headstrong she may come off sometimes. And actually, I do have one story to set straight. We did go running in Auburn. I did tell her to pour alcohol, Tori did fall in a hole and bust her shin open. And I did tell her to pour alcohol on it. I, however, did give a forewarning that alcohol would burn, told you I had no clue if you needed stitches or not, and I made it clear I was not a human doctor. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is why she's marrying one. A couple of tips of advice for the couple. Communicate expectations with one another. You can never over-communicate. Strive to rid yourself of stubbornness and attempt to be the first to apologize. And whenever you grab a snack, always assume the other wants some, even if they say they don't. For the groom, you can never be too clean and tidy, never go to bed too early, have too much dessert, read too many books, and there is never a wrong time to go to Crystal Burger. Josh, I'm excited for you to join our family and to continue to get to know you better. Hearing Tori share how you are everything and more she has prayed for and didn't know she needed is a testament to God's faithfulness. You're a steadiness to her indecisiveness and a calm to her chaos. I'm grateful you bring her the joy, assurance, and solitude she deserves. One of my favorite quotes about marriage by Tim Keller says, "Marriage is a reflection of the gospel. We are more sinful and flawed in ourselves than we ever dared to believe, yet at the very same time, we are more loved and accepted in Jesus than we ever dare hoped. God's love is marked by both radical truthfulness about who we are and yet also radical unconditional commitment to us. I pray you would embrace and love one another fully, despite flaws and shortcomings, as marriage has the tendency to reveal the best and the worst in you. I pray you would envision the person God has designed one another to be and encourage one another in both of y'all's individual and mutual callings. I pray that you seek to understand, serve, and have grace for, and always believe the best in one another. I pray your choice and commitment to one another would lead over your feelings when times get tough. I pray you would have discernment to identify and call out one another's strengths, giftings, and abilities, and be committed to refining one another into the image of Jesus. Lastly, I pray abundant joy over your marriage." Cherished and flourished bond that we have made in lots of years. You are my best friend and the one that I have always looked up to. Although we haven't known Josh for very long, I couldn't have thought of a better person for Tori to share her life with. It's also pretty remarkable. You guys found each other with a 30-mile search radius and no matches for weeks, and then there was one. And so Josh appeared, made the effort to drive to St. Augustine for the first date. I remember talking to Tori after the first date, and she goes, "Yeah, I really think I like this one. He's everything that I prayed for." But then she sat at 72% sure for months. Tori, I cannot think of better half for you girl it was. Also, Tori, you said that you would never be like mom. Well, you have walked in her footsteps and made it look easy to become a lawyer, an engineer, and a pilot. Tori is bright, ambitious, and has a soul that loves. She blends well with Josh's humble and personality. They are a carbon copy of what love really means. And I believe that love is expressed in all of the small moments. Love is gardening when the plants do not thrive. Love is cleaning the house when the other one's at work and watching on the Ring camera. Love is traveling miles just to stay one night in a hotel, shared hotel. Love is leaving sweet notes. Love is going out of your way to take care of family. And sometimes, love is eating very messy chicken wings and going into a food coma. But what it means by all of this is love is eternal, and I cannot wait for more moments to watching y'all's future. We are truly blessed as a family. Plus, I'm glad there's another medical person that I can show the blood and guts to. I can't wait to see what life has in store for you guys. May your love grow stronger each day as you embark on this journey together. May your laughter and joy fill your home. May God bless you in this new beginning. Keep loving each other, preserving the small moments, share wisdom, praise God, and thank God because you guys will be with each other through every phase of life. So raise a glass of tea or water to my sister finally being married. And here's to blue skies, tailwinds, and wherever this life may take you. Cheers to the Russells!
I'm sorry, I didn't use some of your old wrap paper last night. Thank you. You all know him as Joshua. Well, let's take a deeper look into what the name Joshua means. Jay, giant hat. You all know Josh has an above-average head. But let's take a look inside that giant head. We've always known Josh was smart, like really smart. In high school, Josh did a book report and got an A on a book that he didn't read. Or bringing home report cards with 0 for homework and 100% on the test. Or during the sophomore year, completing the year-long report on the bus on the day that it was due. This is all true. It's very smart. I'm so proud of what you have accomplished and everything you have done once you put your mind to it. There's more. You have a couple more letters.
O is for awesome. Josh is an awesome person. He's the most loyal, trustworthy person you'll ever meet. If he tells you he will do something, he will always follow through. For example, when we were kids playing basketball, he said if I pushed him again while doing a layup, he would punch me in the face. And sure enough, he was a man of his word. Josh is the kind of guy who stands up for what he believes in. He's got a compass in his heart that always points to true north. And he never lets anyone or anything shake him off that course. This is why he's been an awesome brother, cousin. By the way, this is her. I'm Jake.
Awesome brother.
Cousin. And why he will be an awesome husband. And there's more.
S. For physical. Victoria, if you're ever looking for a way to motivate Josh, tell me you don't think he can do it. You will find a way. It's the weirdest thing. Telling Josh he can't only makes him want to do it that much more. On a trip to visit Josh in Germany, we plan a trip to snowboard the Swiss Alps, neither of us knowing how to snowboard. We then fell down the mountain for 3 days straight. I still have the scars to prove it. I'm still hurt. Did you feel any of that? You did. You never showed it. Josh doesn't feel pain. Believe me. Go ahead and challenge him to peanut butter. He's the undefeated champ. But anybody that wants to challenge him, go for it. Who breaks their foot playing basketball and finishes the game? Josh does. In a game that didn't matter. It wasn't even like a big game. He just pushed through. He's the guy you want on your side. Victoria, you're in good hands with this guy.
H is for ambitious. Josh is the most not doing person I've ever met. You wouldn't know by talking to him because he doesn't tell anybody anything about all the great things he's done. So I'm gonna just refer to a quick life resume for him. He's 4 years Air Force. He went snowboarding in Austria, skydiving in Switzerland. He is a green belt blue tip. He's lived in Germany, Kyrgyzstan, North Carolina, Washington, Florida. He's done CrossFit competitions. He has six nipples. Graduated as a doctor of something important. He can drive stick shift both in Europe and USA. He is an awesome brother and cousin. And now he's marrying a lawyer turned pilot that I just realized you were an engineer too. It's crazy. And where he's outkicked his coverage by a long shot. I'm sure he's done even more, but he just hasn't told me or anyone that I know. This comes from the person whose version of going out with me would be going to a store, buying a ridiculous amount of food, bringing it home and watching hours of Netflix and doing absolutely nothing. And that's H. And then we have one more. We smushed the last two letters together. UA is for your. This is to Victoria Moore. Your, Victoria, the first person he's ever shown outward affection to. My whole family can attest. I could tell within the first day of seeing you guys together that this was different. He smiled, he laughed, he joked. He actually took pictures. Crazy. He even held hands with you in front of people. That was cool.
He was himself.
Which was awesome. Then you're going to like this guy. He's smart, loyal, strong, ambitious, adventurous. His head is big, but his heart is bigger. Here's to Josh and Victoria.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we're going to bring everybody's attention to the center area where our bride and groom are going to share their first dance. Thought that I should let you know. I think our couple deserves another round of applause. Our next dance for the evening will be the daddy-daughter dance. Let's give this family another round of applause. But this time we're still going to keep the attention on the dance floor because our next dance is the groom with his mother.
Thank you.
Mother.
Hey!
How about 2 decades, 20 years or less? So as the cake unthaws, you know, head on over here and get you some cake as well. But we're going to